Hello sir, good afternoon. My name is Rinaldo Lumain Jr. and I will tackle about the CDI for Traffic Management and Accident Investigation. Education. Education is both the act of teaching knowledge to others and the act of receiving knowledge from someone else. So, both pasabot ani, naghatag ang opinion sa isa ka tao, nagatabang kasi siya para makagate siyang knowledge sa bang siya naman po naghatag po siyang opinion niya kung sa iyang natunan niya para ikaw po masabta pinin mo siya para ka mundo ba nag-gain mo knowledge. So, traffic education describes the traffic rules and regulations in a clear and a simple way. So, kani siya sa describe the traffic rules daw. So, both pasabot ani sa describe the traffic rules kay nag-educate sila sa mga driver o sa mga road users about sa traffic rules and regulations, mga bawal. Then, traffic safety education, due to the role of human factor in the occurrence of accidents. So, sabot po ani niya, nagkuhan sila ng safety education. For example, ano nila, mga teacher na nangatugloan nila kay itong mga government agencies. For example, ano yung government agencies po, ay mga LTO, for example, 911. Sila po yung mga nagkakuha ng traffic safety education. Para po, if na may possible na accidents, dili ta basta-basta manatod. Then, objective of traffic education. Ensuring that novice drivers are trained to recognize risk and potential consequence in order to make reduced risk choice. So, but pasabotan yung objective kung unsa itong naasa traffic education. So, for example, ano yung nasa objective ano nila to mga traffic rules, mga traffic regulations, traffic signs, yun ana. Then, para po matrain po itong mga road users kung na may possible na risk na mahitabo or accidents. So, traffic education measure allows network managers and analyze to both make day-to-day decisions about operations and to plan for long-term developments. So, kaning traffic education measures, sila yung naga-measures para sa pag-develop sa tuwang dalan. For example, nila, para mahanay, then, para ma-analyze sila itong pang-adlaw-adlaw, dagan-dagan sa dalan, minana. So, law related to traffic education. Republic Act 10913. New law that prohibits motorists from using communication device and other gadgets. So, ginapagbawal gud siya na magamit ka o gadget while nag-drive ka. The Republic Act 8750, mandatory compliance by motorists of private and public vehicles to use seatbelt devices. So, mandatory gud siya na gagamit ka o seatbelt even na ka sa front seat or sa back seat backup. Para po na sa imong safety. Republic Act 11229, law that mandate that use of age-appropriate and quality charge system or CRS in motor vehicles and prohibit children below 12 years old to sit beside the driver when the vehicle is moving. So, ginapagbawal po siya na mulingkod sa front seat ang batang nasa edad na 12 pababa. Money blowed sa LTO. Student permit, an official document that authorizes the holder to drive a vehicle in the Philippines in the presence of someone with a professional or non-professional driver license. So, kani siya kay para tong mga tukon ng mga estudyante na mga magkuha student permit para magkuha sila ng professional license or non-professional. Pero dili sila pwede makadrive o vehicle if magasgawa sila dili pwede ang student permit. Pero pwede sila makadrive o vehicle if na sila'y kauban na professional license or non-proof na license na tao. Then, process and procuring student permit. So, muna sila ang process para pagkuha o student permit. Enroll a theoretical driving course or TDC from LTO accredited. Then, get a free TDC from LTO Driver's Education Center. Then, complete all the needed requirements from your student permit application, then go to the LTO office to apply for a student permit.